now request Dr. Rekha to introduce the department.
Wishing a very good afternoon to our respected dean, to the chief guest of today's function and the associate dean of Yenapoya Medical College, Dr. Abhay Nirgude, to all the vice principals, to all the heads of departments and my colleagues and peers, and also all the postgraduates who are listening to this presentation. It gives me immense pleasure to represent the Department of Public Health Dentistry. I am Dr. Rekha Shane, and I have been blessed to head this department. And we are located on the -1 floor of the Dental College building. And today I will be presenting a brief overview of the department, because I think this is a golden opportunity to me to showcase the achievements and the strengths of my department. The Dental College was established in 1992, but the Department of Public Health Dentistry was established in 95. So technically we are the youngest department in the Dental College. And as our goal goes, we are dedicated to training undergraduate and postgraduate students in preventing and controlling disease, oral diseases, investigating risk factors for diseases, promoting oral health, and studying the outcomes of the different interventions and policy decisions that are taken to improve oral health. These are the faculty members in my department. We have one professor, three readers, Dr. Praveen Jodali, Dr. Lakshmi Narayan Sonde, Dr. Imran Pasha, three senior lecturers, Dr. Junaid, Dr. Abdul Aziz, Dr. Namrita, tutors, Dr. Veenu, Dr. Ramshad, Dr. Atifa, and Dr. Ajmal. I have completed my PhD. Dr. Praveen will be finishing his PhD shortly. Dr. Lakshmi Narayan is completed his course in postgraduate diploma in ethics. Dr. Imran is pursuing his FEMA fellowship. And I would also like to mention this about Dr. Veenu. He is the senior most faculty in our department in terms of experience. Recently, we were fortunate enough not just to celebrate his birthday, but also his 25 years in Yenapoya Dental College. This is the picture of the clinical area in my department. It's the postgraduate clinic. We have 9 chairs. Undergraduate clinic, we have 20 chairs. And we are located in the -1 floor of the department. And our OP comes from the patients that are referred from our camps, our outreach programs, and our peripheral centers, which I will come to later. We provide all basic treatment in our department before we refer them for specialized treatment to other departments. We have a well-stocked library. This is what I would like to tell all postgraduate students who have joined this year, that the knowledge in post-graduation is difficult to acquire later when you complete it. So this is the best time for you to gain the maximum knowledge regarding your specialty and regarding other specialties as well. This is our comprehensive clinic. It's located on the 3rd floor alongside the implant clinic, where we have 4 chairs. We have been fortunate enough to receive a great amount of support from the departments of endodontics and prosthodontics, where advanced treatment is provided to our patients without them having to wait for appointments, and most of this treatment is provided for free. This is the dental museum that we have in our department. All these charts or posters that you see here have been made by the faculty, the postgraduate students, the undergraduate students, and our interns. And these are used for all health education programs, whether it's regarding oral health, oral hygiene, different disease awareness. We have also been using this for the anti-tobacco campaign, the cancer awareness program, and the different programs that we conduct, awareness programs that we conduct from our department. These are replaced on a periodic basis by our students. We have 2 mobile dental vans. The one on the left, top left, is our new van. It has 2 chairs, and this van is in great demand from all our camp organizers, and not just from the organizers, but also our team, because it's an air-conditioned van, and working inside gives a lot of comfort. The van on the left is the older van. It has 1 chair. And when I talk about our outreach program, I have to mention the immense amount of support that we receive from all the specialty departments in our college. In specifically, I would like to mention oral surgery department, because From that department, we have one postgraduate student or a faculty member attending each and every camp that we conduct, except our screening programs. So we owe them a debt of gratitude, and I thank them. Our outreach program is very extensive. I think among all the dental colleges in Mangalore, we have the most extensive program. More than 350 camps we conduct every year, covering more than 7,000 patients. And these are the patients who come as our OP. And for conducting the groundwork, doing the publicity, and making arrangements for the facilities for the team, we have agreements or MOUs with more than 50 local organizations and NGOs. And they have done extensive work and supported our community activities. These are some of the camps we have conducted over the past more than 25 years of our department's existence. And we are very active even in the awareness programs. And since we are lucky enough to be associated with the Cancer Awareness Program, which is headed by our Honorable Vice Chancellor, we get a chance to work in screening for oral cancer and all awareness programs, anti-cancer awareness programs that are being conducted by the team. The photograph on the top left shows Dr. Imran. He is conducting an anti-tobacco program at Wenlock Hospital. We also do it in schools, and we have a lot of programs being conducted all over Mangalore and in Udupi, Dakshina Kannada, and Sulya Taluk. These are our peripheral centers. According to the Dental Council of India, we need to have two or three centers. We have five centers which are fully equipped and have full-time faculty posted there. And annually, we have approximately 25,000 patients being treated there and being referred for further treatment to the Dental College. So the first center, the Nathikal Center, was set up in 2012. It is our nearest center, and this is being looked after by Dr. Amshad. The next center is our Zuleika Center. It is the oldest center of our department, and we have the senior most faculty, Dr. Venu, taking care of that center. And that center is located in the building where the Dental College first started. So it's a very iconic place. Next is the Harikala Center, which is managed by Dr. Ajmal. Then we have Dr. Namrata, who's completed her master's in oral medicine and radiology, managing our most distant or furthest center, that is Kakinje. And the newest center that we have set up, that was last April, was the center set up in Jokatte, which is being managed by Dr. Aziz, who has specialized in periodontics. I have to say that I owe them all a big thanks for the amount of effort and energy that they have put up in setting up these centers and ensuring treatment for a steady stream of patients. These are our weekly centers, which we visit on once a week or bi-weekly. And three of them are in association with primary health centers through our MOU with the district health officer, that is Kottikkad, Kurunadu, and Nathikkal. Kumbana Center, we go twice weekly. The other centers, we go once weekly. And these are usually managed by our postgraduate students and our interns. Then we have regular school dental camps. It can either be a screening camp, an awareness camp, or a treatment camp based on the requirements of the school and the permission that we get from the parents and the caregivers regarding what we can do there. Another important activity of our department is the observance of important health days. We have been doing this since the past several years, but I should say that the past 3 years, it has really picked up pace because we have been doing it with the NSS and the local head, that is the YDC head for NSS, Dr. Imran Pasha, coordinates all these activities. So this has raised awareness about different diseases, different health aspects, and we have conducted different programs under these various health days observance, and I think a big part of the credit goes to Dr. Imran. And one specific event that I would like to mention is the one we conducted this February. That was the World Cancer Day observance, where it was the effort of, I should say, almost every faculty member in YDC that we were able to collect an amount of 1 lakh for treatment for giving us treatment for the treatment charges of cancer patients. And I would like to even today say a special thanks to the Department of Periodontics, Endodontics and Orthodontics for their wholehearted contributions. I think it was because of them that we were able to collect such a massive amount. A special thanks also to all the postgraduate students and the interns who participated in the program. In addition, faculty members from our department are part of several programs which have been run at the university level. As I've already said, the NSS coordinator is Dr. Imran. Dr. Imran and Dr. Lakshmi Narayan are members of the Cancer Awareness Outreach Program under the Honorable Vice Chancellor. Then I have been fortunate to be a member of the Center for Environmental Studies and for the Center for Substance Abuse Prevention. So I take part in the add-on course as a resource faculty. Then we have a family adoption program, which has been run since 2012 in association with the Rural Healthcare and Development Center at the university, which is managed by Dr. Poonam Nirgune. And under this, we conduct a socio-demographic and a health survey of each family in the adopted village. This is done by a team of interns, postgraduates, and faculty from both the medical and the dental college. And that specific family is followed up for the entire period as long as that student is here in our campus. So one family is adopted and followed up for five years by that particular team. So from last year, we have started this program for the undergraduates right from first BDS. And this helps to inculcate a sense of community service. So today we have 6 adopted villages and we cover approximately 525 families. Another program we are extensively involved in is the Unnat Bharat Abhiyan, which is a flagship program of the Ministry of Human Resource Development to enrich rural India. So we participated in this program from May 2018 when we did the basic survey of all the villages. It was due to the tireless efforts of our faculty and interns that we were able to complete the survey within 15 to 20 days. And after that, we have been regularly conducting health programs, health screening programs, educational programs, and even recently, we participated in a campaign to eliminate plastic use. From the department, we regularly conduct CD programs, workshops, and symposia. I would like to say with a lot of pride that our former head of department, Dr. Ganeshan A. Panchmar, was the head of the oral health program for the state of Karnataka. And he conducted 2 symposia, as a result of which we brought out the oral health policy for the state of Karnataka, which was handed over to the state government. And as a result of which, today we have the Dantabhagya Yojana implemented. We have antenatal checkup for pregnant women, which has been made mandatory. And we are also having an increased employment opportunities for dental graduates and postgraduates in the sub-centers, primary health centers, and community health centers. In addition, we have collaborations with the University of North Carolina, where students have been coming in, and this program has been coordinated by Dr. Sandeep Shetty from the department. Sandeep Shetty from the Department of Orthodontics, and we have had students coming in and observing the working both in our outreach program and in our peripheral centers. We have the Dantabhagya Yojana MOU with the Government of Karnataka. Recently, we have adopted a village. We have MOUs with the District Health Office and with several NGOs and institutions for the elderly, the destitute, and the physically and mentally challenged, where we regularly provide care. These are some of the places where we have been working over the past 10 years. Coming specifically to the PG program, our PG program in our department started in 2006. We have 2 PGs per year, and till we went in for an enhancement in 2012, and we followed the DCI regulations, which were revised as recently as in 2019 with regard to the syllabus for the PG program in public health dentistry. Also, we have incorporated certain aspects and syllabus revisions, which have passed through our academic council. And this is mainly to increase clinical exposure to patients in our department. And this was based on the feedback that we took from our stakeholders. So basically, the academic program in public health industry can be divided into 3 main streams. The first is basic sciences, public health, and dental public health. So most of our theoretical teachings and discussions focus on these 3 topics. This is the timetable for postgraduate work in our department. Usually we spend the first 1.5 hours of every day with some academic presentation. And this may change based on if we have any outreach program in the department or any other program which the postgraduates are supposed to attend. And then they go in for patient care or either for medical center posting or for research and academic activities, which may either be their thesis or their short projects or their library dissertations or publications. But one thing which is different from other departments, I would say, except oral surgery, is the camp posting. We have on an average 45 to 50 Sunday camps every year. So we are working almost every Sunday. And sometimes we have 2 camps every Sunday. So our work has been possible due to the massive support that we have from other departments and from, I would say, the non-teaching staff and the postgraduates. I'm really grateful to them, and I'm also grateful to our dean, beloved dean Dr. Arthur Hussain, because since sir has taken over, he has made it mandatory for postgraduate students from all departments to participate in our camps. In addition, a postgraduate student in our department will participate in denture camps, cancer screening camps, awareness programs, field visits to places of public importance. In shortly, in all activities which are conducted by our department. For the first year PGs in specific, every Friday for the first 6 months, basic classes are conducted by the faculty from Yenapoya Medical College. These are mainly in the form of seminar presentations in the basic subjects, and also they have classes in biostatistics and research methodology. I request all postgraduate students especially to take advantage of the classes that they have in research methodology and biostatistics, because that is very important whenever you are doing any kind of academic presentations, especially journal clubs and critical evaluations. This is the minimum quota of academic and clinical exercises that are to be performed in our department over the 3 years of the course. A dissertation synopsis which has to be submitted within 6 months, a dissertation to be submitted 6 months before completion, a library dissertation to be completed within 18 months, and specifically for our subjects, 2 short-term research projects to be completed in 3 years. And for all postgraduate students, please make sure that your attendance does not fall below 80% in each academic year. This is very important. Regarding record maintenance, we ensure that our postgraduate students maintain a daily logbook. And as our Vice Principal Sir Shambhat Sir has already mentioned, and he has also shown in his presentation, there are evaluation forms for every type of academic presentations for pedagogy exercises. Regarding pedagogy, I would like to mention that in our department, we revise the curriculum to enhance the number of pedagogy exercises and also the different methods of audiovisual aids to be used, and also the clinical exercises. The evaluation is both formative and summative. In post-graduation, it is a formative evaluation, which is of utmost importance because you learn throughout the course. So in addition to a continuous evaluation on a day-to-day basis of whatever academic or clinical work that you do, there is an overall monthly evaluation every month. We also do a biannual and an annual evaluation, the reports of which are submitted to the Office of the Dean, YDC, and mock exams are conducted at the end of every academic year for each postgraduate student who enters our college. And this is especially, I wouldn't have shown this slide except for the fact that you have a university exam at the end of the first year of the course in first MDS, that is your basic sciences paper. This has been implemented from the last 2 years. You have 3 hours duration, 10 questions of 10 marks. This is especially vital, so you remember to focus in your classes on basic sciences. This is the other exercises and exercises to be kept in mind during the university exam, but that will be at the end of 3 years. And our campus, the USP of our campus, I would like to say, is the access to additional courses which are available throughout. One is the training in tobacco cessation. It can be courses on bioethics, medical ethics, forensic anthropology, odontology, implantology, restorative and aesthetic dentistry, and so many CDs, workshops, and symposia that are conducted in our campus and in so many dental and medical colleges that we have in Mangalore. I think this has come to a stop because of COVID, but still it is a learning opportunity that cannot be duplicated elsewhere. and all postgraduate students from our department for the past 2 years have been attending workshops on systematic review and meta-analysis and literature review at CMC Vellore. In addition, we have contributions from our department to our specialty textbook, that is Sobhan Peter. As a young department, I would take great pride in saying that we have 63 research projects, 59 publications. The highest impact factor of one is 2.01. We have 4 projects with research funding. And these are the awards that the faculty, the postgraduate and undergraduate students have won in relation to academics from our department. I would especially like to highlight the two awards which come under department category. One was the Best Anti-Lagging Film Award. This was in the competition that was a National University Filmmaking Competition, which was launched by the University Grants Commission to combat ragging in educational institutions. One of our postgraduate students who passed out last year, Dr. Kiran Shankar, he made a movie called The Unsighted, which won the 9th place and a prize amount of rupees 1 lakh at the national level. And another is we won the first prize in the short film contest titled Journey for a Smile. It was at our national conference in 2018. This film was made by a team of postgraduate, undergraduate students and faculty. I would specifically like to mention postgraduate students from the Department of Prosthodontics, Public Health Dentistry, who contributed immensely to the making of this film, and it was based on the Dantabhagya Yojana. So I thank you all for a patient listening, and I think the person who presents at the end always gets the benefit of seeing what everybody else before has presented and adding to your own presentation. So I thank all the heads of departments who have presented before me for contributing to this presentation. And I would like to stop with a saying which is very close to my heart. And if I say that, I know you will identify where it comes from. So it's from a very famous Hindi movie, and it says that agar dil se kisi cheez ko chaho to sari kainat tumhe usse milane ki koshish mein lag jati hai. That is, if you desire something with all your heart, the entire universe conspires to unite you with what you desire. So you have started a new life of professionalism, a new life of professional advancement and integrity. So a journey of 1,000 miles begins with a single step. So I wish every one of you all the best, and I thank you for a patient listening. And when you have time, please come to our department. Thank you.